गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स इन टूडेज क्लास वी लर्न अबाउट द गॉसेस लॉ एंड इट्स स्टेटमेंट एंड वी ऑल्सो अंडरस्टूड अबाउट इट्स एप्लीकेशन एंड हाउ अप्लाइड गॉस लॉ ऑन द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ चार्जेस। ओके, तो सबसे पहले हम समझते हैं What is the statement of this Gauss law? Okay, so it states that the net electric flux linked with any closed surface is equal to one upon epsilon naught times the net charge enclosed within the surface This is the statement of Gauss's law. Okay. Therefore, the net electric flux is equal to Q upon epsilon naught, where Q is net charge enclosed within the surface. Given surface. Okay. As we learn in the previous class that flux is given by closed integral of vector E dot vector ds. So by using this we can say that the net electric flux of closed surface vector E ds is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. Okay, so this is the mathematical form of the Gauss's law. Okay, now we understood about first about the kind of surface for which we can calculate the Gauss law. Okay, see, the surface for which we can calculate electric field by using this Gauss law is Gaussian surface. Okay, what is this? So specialty of the Gaussian surface is the electric field linked with the or we can say electric field lines of forces linked through the spatially or special Gaussian surface is equal at every point. And we can also specify the angle between the electric field and area vector. As we understood in the previous class that for many practices we can consider the area as a vector. Okay, now suppose we have a cuboid like this. So as you know, a cube has the six surfaces. One is downward, one is upward, one is left and one is right, and one is in forward direction and one is in backward direction. Okay, so the area vector is always, as you learn in the area vector concept, the area vector is always perpendicular to the surface. Okay, which means normal to the surface. This is the surface, or you can easily find the angle between the area vector and the surface. If this is the area vector and this is surface, so you can easily find that the angle between the surface and the area vector is 90 degree. Okay, and if we use this, so again it is 90 degree, and for every situation it is always 90 degree. Clear? So this is about the area vector and its direction from the surfaces facing you. If any surface facing you, so area vector is determined by two direction, which means suppose we have this board, okay, or on this board there is a plane like this. Okay, we just discussed about this plane area. Okay, so for this plane area, at this point electric field should be out from the surface, which means area vector should be outward from the surface. And if we take the another, the similar surface, for this case we can conclude that the electric field is inward the surface, or outward from the plane of paper and inward from the plane of paper. So when we define this area vector dA in direction of unit vector n cap, so for this situation we can say that the area vector is coming out from the plane of paper. And for this, if we define in such a way that this is the direction of area vector with the unit vector eta cap, okay, we can say area vector dA dash or eta cap dash. So at this point the direction of area vector we can say that crossward, which means inward. Clear? So these are the two directions. We can see the area vector is inward or outward. ये दो cases ऐसे हैं. Suppose ये है एक situation, तो इस case में area vector is from the forward direction, and for this case is from the backward direction. But if you are facing this face, so area vector in direction to you, and I am facing the opposite face, then area vector is in direction to me. ठीक है, दूसरी situation, basically we conclude this relation with the electric field. Now understood. Suppose this Let's say this red marker is expressing the surface. This is direction of area vector vertically upward, and an electric field is moving in such a way. Okay, you can easily find, and then after it crosses the surface like that. Clear? Then we can say the direction of electric field and area vector is in the same direction. Therefore, they are parallel to each other but normal to the surface. Therefore, you can easily say that the angle between the electric field and the area vector is 0 degree. Clear? Okay. If the electric field is moving along with the surface like that, so you can easily specify the angle between the area vector and the electric field is 90 degree. And the another case is like that, in which the electric field is moving vertically down, okay, moving vertically down through the surface, but area vector in forward direction. So we can say that the electric field is inward to the plane of paper, and in this particular case the area vector and the electric field is parallel to each other but the angle between the two is 180 degree. Clear? And for this particular case they are parallel to each other and the angle between the area vector and the electric field is 0 degree. Then you can, I think, easily understood about the situations, how to specify the angle between the area vector and electric field. Now I can just explain you in the same manner here. Okay, now understood again. For this point O, or for this small area dA, this is total surface and this is a small area. Similarly, this is a small area dA and the area vector is moving normal to the surface. Normal to the surface in direction of eta cap as dA. Clear? Now, for a particular situation, for this point, the electric field is moving like that. This is the direction of electric field. Okay? And for this particular case, the direction of electric field is downward. So for this, we can say the electric field is radially or normal to the surface outward. And for this case, you can say the electric field is normal to the surface inward. Clear? These are the two situations. And the another case is, okay, for this particular case, theta is equal to 180 degree between E and A. And for this case, theta is equal to 0 degree between E and A. Clear? So these are the two situations, and you can calculate the value of flux through the closed surface E D A is equal to closed surface E D S cos theta. And I will also form the third situation, for which this is the direction of dA normal to the surface
and this is the direction of electric field, which is 90, which means theta is equal to 90 degree, and which is angle between E and A. Clear? These are the three situation. For this particular situation, the value of this is EDS, because cos 0 degree become 1. Okay, next is, for this particular case, EDS is equal to closed integral EDS minus 1 for cos 180 degree is minus 1. And here you can calculate this flux through the surface is vector E dot vector DS E DS cos 90 is 0. So I think you can easily understood about the basic three situations for which the electric flux EDS is maximum and electric flux EDS is minimum. Okay, these are some cases. Now we understood about the surface. Okay, a Gaussian surface, it is a surface for which value of electric field at every point is seen, and angle between E and A, or we can say DA, vector E and vector DA, which we can use theta, is same at all. Okay, is same at every point. Therefore, a Gaussian surface have symmetrical for electric field and angle between electric field and area vector at every point. Okay, here we can calculate the value of some special surfaces or specified surfaces, that is spherical surface, cylindrical surface and a plane surface, but by using this we can calculate the electric field for any surface. But after that we have some special surface. One is for a point charge.
okay, for a point charge, suppose we have a point charge kept at point O of magnitude Q. Okay, so for calculating the electric field by using the Gaussian surface, Gauss's law, so we can consider a Gaussian surface, okay, which is usually in the spherical form, and as according to Gauss theorem, the total charge is always referred to the surface. Okay, so now you can easily observe here the value of electric field at every point is 90, and for the same point the area vector is dA if we considered this particular surface. So you can find the area vector and electric field is normal to the surface at a single point, then you can calculate here the theta is equal to 0 degree. Okay, and in the starting classes we understood that the for a point charge the electric field is always normal to the spherical surface, or for a point charge it is radially outward if it is a positive charge. So at every point, because it is a spherical surface, the radius is every point is similar, and the electric field and area vector have the same angle. So this is the first kind of surface. Dusra hamare paas ho jata hai students, that for a line charge distribution, for a line charge distribution, now suppose you have given a wire of length L, okay, and having charge distributed to its length uniformly. ठीक है, लेट से दिस चार्ज इज इक्वल टू क्यू एंड इट इज गिवन बाय लैम्डा एल. सो इफ वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट द इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स फॉर द लीनियर चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, सो यू नीड टू कंसिडर अ गाउसियन सरफेस लाइक अ सिलेंडर. दिस for that the radius for a cylinder is same at every point. Okay, now the cylinder has three surfaces, one is surface S1, this is surface S2, and this is surface S3. Clear? Now understood here the electric field for every point is crosses normally from its axis like this. Clear? Now these are the direction of electric field which you can calculate here. Every electric field is normal to the surface in the right side, and similarly to the left side it is normal. Clear? Therefore the area vector at this surface is dA, which is also normal to the surface, and for this particular case this is the direction of area vector. So you can find this is the direction of area vector. So you can find a cylinder has three surface, two flat
and one curved. Okay, and for this particular case, when the linear charge is considered as the axis of cylinder of charge, ठीक है, then for this electric field theta is 90 degree and for this theta is 0 degree between E and A. It is very clearly understood by your side. So if you have given a line charge distribution, you can consider a cylinder whose axis is the charge or linear charge distribution. And third kind of surface which we discussed here, for a plane sheet, plane charge sheet. Okay, if you have given a plane charge sheet, okay, so you can consider here the charge is uniformly distributed over the surface of this sheet. Then you can find the electric field is processed from the sheet is normally to the surface. This. So, which kind of Gaussian surface taken for to calculate this? So, suppose this you have the charge sheet in which the charge equally distributed. Okay, so you need to take a cylinder crossing the surface like that. This, when the surface is crosses with the plane sheet, some part of this sheet is kept inside the hollow spherical surface. Okay, therefore you can calculate the situation. Let's say it is a hollow cylinder, then you can observe that some charge is left with the cylinder. For this, when you face it, so you will find it is like a spherical surface. Okay, for which the electric field is calculated. Okay, so these are some situations, and for this kind of surface you have charge is equal to sigma A. Okay, sigma is the charge density and A is the area of the surface. So these are some special Gaussian surfaces for which we can calculate the value of electric field by using this surface. Now we take the proof of Gauss's law. Friends, now we prove the Gauss law by using it for any surface, any closed surface. Okay, we consider a surface like that, and we can consider it, the surface is made up of small surfaces like ds1, ds2, ds3 and dsn. Okay, this, for the particular surface, a small surface any small surface ds on this surface for which electric field at point P is calculated. Okay, now we understood some situations. Let's say it is a 3D situation. So this is a particular sphere which makes an angle d, let's say d omega, a solid angle at the center O or at point O of radius r at this point. This is the particular point P where need to calculate at r distance value of electric field. So the charge is moving or electric field is moving radially outward in the particular direction. Therefore, the area vector for this point is normal to the field is vector ds making an angle theta with the electric field. Clear? Therefore, at this point P for the small surface, you can calculate the electric flux through the surface. This is the total surface S. Therefore, you can say that the small flux, small electric flux, small electric flux d phi for a small surface, ds is, you have that closed integral of surface E ds, vector E dot vector ds. You can calculate this result is E ds cos theta. Okay, let's see, this is equation first. Now we know that electric field for a small charge or electric field for point charge at distance r is given by E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square. This is your equation second. Therefore, from equation 1 and 2, we can calculate that the closed integral of electric flux E dot ds, this is actually what? So answer is electric flux E dot ds is equal to closed integral of surface, this is only for the small surface. Okay, this is for a small surface E ds. This we are using here d phi. Okay, this is d phi is equal to value of E by using here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square into ds cos theta. Okay, this is your equation third. Now, total flux total flux through the surface. Through the surface is equal to phi e, which is closed integral of surface d phi. Okay. Now, when we use this value, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square into ds cos theta, then we find here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q closed integral of surface ds cos theta upon r square in the square, because here is radius, because at this point the radius is r, but at this point is not equal to r. Let's say it is r1, at this point it is r2, at this point it is r3, at this point it is r4, and similarly at different point the radius should be different. So we can use radius is not constant, this result. And as you learn 4 pi epsilon naught q, this is value of d omega, where d omega is equal to this, where d omega equal to ds cos theta upon r square and known as solid angle. Okay, this. Now in the next line we can use here that electric flux is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into 4 pi, because the complete value of solid angle d omega is equal to 4 pi steradian. Therefore this 4 pi cancel this 4 pi and we calculate or we find that result is equal to q upon epsilon naught, which is proof of Gauss law. Okay, so this is how you can prove the Gauss's law for any surface. Okay, next, as a note, I will prove it for a closed surface, closed spherical surface. Okay, next, for a spherical surface. Okay, this is a spherical surface. You can consider a spherical Gaussian surface as having charge plus q at center with radius r, as shown in figure. Now, the spherical surface is considered as made up of small surfaces ds1, ds2 and so on up to dsn. For a small surface ds, electric field at a point P is calculated, and angle between E and A is 0 degree at all, or you can say at every point. Therefore, okay, now understood here, this is the direction of electric field, and at the same point the direction of area vector is also in the direction of electric field. Then this situation we observe. Therefore, the small electric flux d phi for the small surface ds is given by this. Because theta is 0 degree, you can say that this value ds only
because cos 0 degree is 1. Okay. Now, we know that the result is this. Therefore, d phi is equal to, in placing here, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q ds upon r square. This is equation third. Okay. Now, the total flux linked with surface is phi is equal to integral s d phi. By using this result, we can calculate that 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square ds. Now, students, r square for a radius or a radial surface is constant, then therefore this phi is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square, and this is closed integral of surface ds. Now we use here the surface area of a charge sphere, which is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square into 4 pi r square, because total surface area of a sphere is 4 pi r square. Clear? Then you easily cancel out this and get the result for the flux is q upon epsilon naught. This is the second way to prove the Gauss's law for a spherical surface. Okay. Thank you.